Oh.
I think I found the crew.
What, this?
Are they also bloodied up, like the guy under the floor?
You could say that. I'm not sure how many people I'm looking at.
I thought it was just blood.
It's like something from a eugenics war painting.
Try to push through, John. A few decks below. One step at a time.
Hmm. Disturbing evidence of slaughter. Yeah. Okay. I figured this is just more slaughter. I figured he'd be fine. PDA. Oh god. All this slimy. Sadie A. Callister. Okay. So she's the one that helped Erica get the shift changed. And then afterwards started looking at her... Erica strangely, as Erica started locking her quarters, I believe. What she said. September 18th. Crazy huge brawl in the mess hall today. I thought that becoming the new head medical tech on this desk, on this deck, would actually improve things. Wait a second. Oh. Alright. It doesn't have the, what do you call it? The same opening line. But it's like being thrown into the lion's den. The lockdown a few months back where it was a pain, but these inventory discrepancies are the real problem. And then yesterday the systems went haywire. The first thing Erica does, of course, is call up her little sister to make sure she's okay. I suppose I can understand that. I just wish that, well, I wish she'd asked after me sometimes, too. Yesterday during the power outage I was locked inside a storage room for 2 hours. But Danica's fine, of course, so who cares about me? I was only trapped in a product storage room with only plant cultures and human limbs for company. I took a look at them, actually. It's part of my job, with the plants anyway, and I had to do something to keep my mind off things. Good specimens, all of them, except for specimens 99D, E, and F. I couldn't for the life of me work out why samples this badly mutated would be permitted anywhere near the greenhouses. Those are recent, too. Dear God, what imbecile in shipping sent these to storage? Kane's Hydroponics have the strictest quarantine regulations in the galaxy. Punishable by losing your damn job. It must be that new section a few floors down. They've got all kinds of fools on the payroll. You know, I actually like to spend time in the greenhouses, but I swear something's going funny with some of the new crops. Erica said I'm probably just imagining it, but I've had a whole batch, of brassica growth cultures thrown out the other day, showing signs of what looked like Dutch elm disease. How is that possible? I'm going to submit a report. How am I supposed to explain to Dr. Mallon and the board that we have mutant cultures in storage and perfectly good crops with extinct diseases is another matter. Kind of curious here. So, December 20th, Erica's lost her damn mind. I'm scared out of my mind right now. She's dragged us on a fool's errand across the ship to look for Danica. I tried to tell her... Erica, Danica, there's a family thing going on with the names. I tried to tell her how I saw one of those things wearing Danica's face the other morning. Really? Wearing her face? What? Oh god, it makes me want to puke just thinking about it. It looked like a deflated balloon as it scuttled up the walls. I swear Ingracia fried it with a bolt, but we can't be sure. He's a psychiatrist, not a soldier. Then again, are any of us soldiers? So wait, literally wearing her face? Or, like, camouflage changed its colorings or markings to make it look like her face. Because those are two very different things. Poor Danica's going without her face, then. So that's... yeah. Then the fool's errand, because she's... dead. Turned into a little leather face bug thing. Erica seems to think we're in the Marine Corps, waving around that rifle with a crazy look in her eye, threatening to kill anyone who disagrees with her. Erica, I told her, you're a nurse. God, I barely recognize her anymore. What happened to my best friend? What happened to that girl from Stokely, Mississippi? I don't know who Erica Boxer is anymore. Well, they're both making each other uneasy. December 24th. Erica died this morning. My friend is gone. One of those horrific things tore her spine out of her body right in front of my eyes. It must be one of the last ones left alive. Not that I've got long. I'm infected with something. I can feel it. I checked out the hydroponics lab this morning. It's a wreck. I could have told them Anyone could have told them that trying to breed a new fungus to kill the old one would be disastrous. The rest of it won't budge. I've tried tearing it away with the laser scalpel Erica gave me, but it did nothing. Zip, zilch, nada. What doesn't kill it really does make it stronger. I'm going back to retrieve Erica's remains later. I know she died a crazy woman, but she was my friend. I still love her. So we got this fungus going on. People trying to remove it and to no avail. My friend is gone. Yeah. Notices and reports. Read personal data tags. Is this the same thing? You'll know by now. Say the word is edges. Okay, that's the same thing I've read. Yeah. Emails. From S.A. Callister, Sadie Callister, to Dr. G. Mallon, re-inventory anomalies, right? So this is her to Dr. Mallon, the psycho dude, wherever he actually is residing on this vessel. Dr. Mallon, first, allow me to apologize for mailing you directly, but this is a classified red emergency. I've undertaken further inspections beyond samples 99D, E, and F, and found that the majority of our inventory has been compromised by tampering. There are signs that the tampering began some time ago. Some of the materials are merely spoiled, but a large quantity appears to have been illegally modified. I'm not sure who the new suppliers are, but the inventory they have provided does not match the chemical manifest included. I'm aware this is a shipping concern rather than a hydroponics one, but Project Seed is based around our successful cultivation of hypernutritious plants in unusual conditions. With the current stock we possess, there is no limit to the number of illegal or mutated nutrients going into our plant growth. I'd advise that shipping and medical begin more thorough inspections of the received cargo. I suspect the problems could go back for months, although I have no evidence to prove this. Please recommend immediate termination of supply runs and decontamination of irrigation pipes until this is resolved. Best regards, Sadie Canister, Hydroponics Technician Level 1. Wow. Alright, this portal. What am I supposed to be doing here? I can't get to the portal. Okay, I don't know. Alright. Well, I don't know how to activate this elevator. Anything else? Oh, right. There was this blood and tissue. We can pick this up, apparently. Why we'd want that? The oozing red goop contains flecks of bone and masses of tissue. Lovely. Body part. Can't look through the portal. So this goes to reception. And this goes somewhere else. Should we go to reception?
Wound formed the wound. Oh, never again. It crawled through the night, and then, they crafted their eyes, and tore through my skin. Oh, never ever, never again. They came for our mothers and then for our kin, scratching the belt and eating my sin, changing God's work, a seed to begin. We burn them with fire and kill them with men. Let us remember, never again.
Where are these recordings coming from? Entrance to the medical facilities. Main medical deck entrance security door. The flickering lights draw morbid attention to the arcs of blood staining the wall. PDF or something, or medical bay terminal. Reception chair. It's as if the chair has turned shyly away from the sight of the bloodshed nearby. The contours of the sleek reception desk perfectly mirror the curvature of the walls. Oh, wonderful. One of these radios?
Kane Corporation, the last truly great company, wants to thank all employees for their dedicated service. This year's profits are up 20% across all sectors. Life expectancy is up 5 years. We are at the cusp of greatness. In the words of Henry Kane himself, humanity has chosen us to do its good work, and together we will not let them down. Kane Corporation, tomorrow's technology, today.
Okay.
Hey you, yes you over there. Ensure that you stay clean of parasites at all times. Mandatory rectal exams are to be enforced.
Oh boy.
Brought to you by Kane Health and Safety.
You sounded weird. Medical Bay Terminal is here though. Ah! Personal data tag detected, John Marichak. Personal data tag has no security clearance. System is locked. Oh, we can't do anything there then. At least for now. Well, we need to get a better tag. Or get ours removed, the other one. I guess we'll go this way. You can't begin to estimate how many lives were ended here. Bloodstained environment suits. These suits look relatively intact, despite the new decorations splattering their surfaces. Or spattering, rather. Well, we can take this one. Though they're saturated in human ichor, the suits are in working order. Charged plasma molecules dart across the surface of an invisible electrical field. Oh, isn't this mean we get a view? I don't want to go through it.
Serotonergic receptors are present in your principal vascular system.
Okay. It's like an abstract painting. From one angle, it's the handiwork of something mindless and automated. But from another, these brushstrokes are angry with rage, or worse, indiscriminate and gleeful. There's more this way. Then we can take that one. I just wanna... It looks like he's walking towards the force field, which... Does that kill you? I don't even know. Just in case it does... This is, before I give us an eye view of everything... So we can see what's in here visually, but not examine anything. So I want one of these suits. Oh, I got an oxygen cylinder, actually.
Derogatory comments or other intimidating actions directed at Kane security employees.
This should be useful.
Oxygen cylinder wrapped with cables. I have no idea why.
I think that would break. Maybe. No. This isn't going to work.
Alright, so I got this thing wrapped with cables. Medical machinery. Unlike much of the other machinery, this terminal was designed to assist in healing. Extracted PDT. Ooh. Several bent spinal hooks protrude from disengaged personal data tag. And a PDA. Okay, so PDA, PDT is a tag. I got it. Surgical pod bed. With a beneficiary or victim, this is where the surgery patients lie. I pointed at the other thing, though.
Of course! They must have manually removed the PDTs. That's why the security systems were reset in medical.
Did I kill her?
Bodies. The bodies in the crew quarters. They were skinned. The creatures were using the PDTs
right.
to move through secure areas.
We knew that, but now I see why they're skinned.
What was going on?
So for me to get to the lower decks?
You have to remove your tag.
Remove?
Perhaps electric shock. No, that wouldn't work.
An operation.
John? This is the only surefire way.
What are you saying?
Surgery.
The surgery pod should already be programmed to remove it.
Yep.
It didn't work out so well for this poor woman.
Mm-hmm.
It's the only way, unless you space jump between decks.
This is surgery.
John, prep the pod.
Don't tell me what to do, lady. Tell me to prep the pod. Anesthetic storage. In a surgery suite, at least one of these would be anesthetic. Your guess is that it's this one. Cryopreservation tank. This thick viscous soup is a cocktail of a cryoprotectant and synthetic amniotic fluids. Oxygen storage tank. The steel tank stores oxygen-rich compounds under high pressure. Pipes. You imagine yourself as a doctor in a space opera, barking a sharp line of dialogue to identify this piece of machinery. Really? Main surgery pod base. A high-end surgery pod sophisticated enough to perform nearly any operation with a tiny margin for error. Yeah, I think we need to extend that margin. A modesty curtain. It takes you a few moments, but the joke hits hard. Discarded hospital bed. A call to rest, to sleep. I just want to go to sleep. Anything else? We can mess with all these tanks, apparently. Do you want to go to sleep? Let's see if he'll say anything about it. No. Alright, let's look at this PDA here. Oh, there's that doctor, yeah. Isaiah Al Rajkupar? January 8th, a new year for the chief surgeon. Oh, wow, it was almost like a year before everything went to hell. And a new year for the chief of the medical deck. I have to think of it that way, or it gets rather confusing. The staff of the medical deck now consists of three extra sections: cybernetics, tissue regeneration, and for some reason, medicinal hydroponics. Yes, it may be medicinal, but as I told Dr. Malin, they are still plants. I don't wish to seem ungrateful. It is Kane Corporation who opened so many new doorways for me, and who redefined the frontiers of medicine for us all. As a man who served his apprenticeship on the battlefields, elbow deep in the blood of innocence, to see those deserts and war-torn villages reborn as images of nirvana is a privilege, and all thanks to the sciences of Kane. And yet, it's hard to understand why, on the Groomlake, so many departments are being forced to share resources like this. I hear our budget will be up for review soon, and the chances of us getting an increase are slim. I shall try to remain positive. Just looking at this thing, can't really see, read any of it. Try to remain positive. February 18th. My goodness, a 300% budget increase. I have not yet been able to even imagine how helpful this financial windfall will be. It's going to be for a reason tied to all this, and not good, because then this is good. Dr. Malin assured me that a sizable portion of this project will be applied to Project Seed. It makes our work that much more essential. We'll order new equipment and new samples, although I don't totally agree with the ethics of Dr. Malin's acquisition of volunteers for surgery and testing. The leaps and bounds we've made in our research more make up for the rest of it. Is it wrong that we must test the limits of morality for the greater good? Yes. Is wrong. What are new equipment, new samples? Yeah, so he knows what's going on with the volunteers, quote-unquote, the people in the stasis pods. May 4th. I'm a surgeon who has seen many awful things in the blood-soaked abattoirs of the Pangaea Wars, so perhaps this should be second nature to me, but I don't recall agreeing to the use of children for testing. I went to inspect the stasis tubes at the request of my chief nurse, and found that there were several children, some as young as 9 years old, awaiting processing. Children? I was shocked and appalled and demanded an explanation from Dr. Mahler. Edward Jenner had to test vaccines on children to see if they'd work, he said. I knew the story, but medical does not. Jenner injected infected purulent exudates into the child's arm, which must have seemed callous disregard for the child's life, and yet it saved the boy. That is how he convinced me. We are at the frontier of the sciences. Oh my God. Are you really that naive? Chances must be taken. I do not always feel comfortable with his ethical choices, but his logic is sound. The research is too valuable for us to let a few moral qualms get in our way. Oh, then you're one of the bad guys. Purulent exudates. What, is this story even true? I doubt it. I mean, maybe? December 17th. I fear that my decision to become a surgeon with Kane Corporation is not quite as simple as I thought. The first casualties of the infection spreading across the ship came to my lab, where we had to set up a quarantine operating room. I had to get hands-on with the patient for the first time in years. The flow of blood, the cut of the infected tissue under my specialized tools. God forgive me, but I enjoyed it. It's impossible to explain the adrenaline rush from playing God in such a way, of having the lives of so many on the verge of death in your hands. I felt it on the battlefields, and I feel it now. So I don't think most doctors feel this way. Could be wrong. I'm not a doctor. Definitely not a surgeon. It is not the beauty of birth that moves me, it seems, but the pungent stench of death. I thought I'd join Kane Corporation to save my soul. Instead, it is to slake the thirst of the beast in me, whose jaws slaver at the scent of blood. I am ashamed. You should be. December 20th. How can I not have seen it? Those awful life forms are disguising themselves as us, inside us. They wear our skins and our PDTs, which explains how the security systems cannot detect them. If I didn't already know where those creatures came from, this would perhaps be less frightening. But they've learned, the vile abominations. Abomination. What a word that is. It appears to summarize what we have created in our hubris. We have created evil. God help us all. Notices and reports. Personal data tags would be the same thing, right? Yeah, ages. Never get another notice saying that the word has changed. Said that's just a word for today. With no follow-up. Does this have a date on it? No. Unfortunately, no. Emails from Dr. C. Backman to Dr. Raj Kapoor. Reanalysis report. Ooh, Dr. Mallon. Actually, the nurse. Okay, analysis report. Dr. Mallon has recalibrated his guidelines for subjects in Project Seed, and specifically the requirements for any female subjects who have previously been pregnant. The female subjects should ideally have been screened, but their precise source is not important, since the project has a 99.89% chance of a non-fatal reaction in subjects. Members of staff will be eligible for this test. The ideal subject is as follows. This is the one that the one girl, the 17-year-old, wanted to up in entertainment. Stacy? Entertainment lounge or whatever? She wanted to volunteer for this, but if you had an abortion or something like that, or a miscarriage, I forget which one she said, it doesn't count. Blood type, O negative. Height between 5'5 and 6'0. Free of any genetic defects. Between 18 and 40. Oh no, it's because he was 17. Subjects must have recently been pregnant. Ideally within the past year. Regards, Dr. C. Backman. I wonder if his wife is pregnant. She might not even told him. Was going in cryogenic suspension, like kind of freeze the gestation process so that she won't give birth in 9 months inside a tube. I just saw, but I don't know how long this trip was anyway. To Dr. G. Mallon. Oh, from Dr. Rashkabor. Okay. Re the nurse. We have disagreed often, but never so more than now. I'm afraid that Ms. Callister doesn't work in surgery, and that Chief Nurse Boxer has seniority in terms of rank. All right. Callister is, Sarah? Not Sarah. Starts with an S. I can't remember her name. However, Callister has one of the most extraordinary organizational minds I've ever worked with. The product storage areas are clean and well indexed. Therefore, I have to challenge your demand that I remove her from your position because of these false reports she has been sending you about anomalies in the supplies. I have no doubt that your claims of her illicitly taking samples is also only an accusation. She's a fine worker and reports only what she feels is right. I'll be taking no action against her. You're in charge of the project, but you must allow me to choose my staff at my discretion. Regards, Isaiah. What's her name? Callister? I'm just trying to remember the name. It's right here. Sadie. Not Sarah, Sadie. Okay, so she's the one you wanted to remove because she was... I wonder what we can do with this portal. Alright, I'm gonna have to do some surgery on myself now. Sounds wonderful, huh? So it's extracted PDTs here. Several bent spinal hooks protrude from a personal data tag. So what am I gonna do with that? Oxygen storage tank? Oh, I took it. Empty stasis fluid container. Anesthetic storage.
Is not properly prepared for the selective program.
Did I take that too?
This is a friend in the room. It's what crime doesn't fail death. This is a final request for the Holy Bayon to report to communications array 18.
Organic receptacle. A protein and fat storage container. We also have this wrapped with cables.
The MedTech surgical pot is not properly prepared for the selective program.
Empty stasis fluid container.
I don't know what I was thinking there.
So we want to fill this with something. Organic receptacle. We put the body part in there? Or the tag? But I want to remove the tag.
Okay, organic matter receptacle requires refined biological tissue.
So is it because I'm going to use this skin to cover up the skin in removing the personal data tag?
These don't go well together.
Surgical tray. The stainless steel tray bears a faint splatter of biological tissue across its surface. Do I want to refine this? Is that what I want to do? Medical machinery. Okay, put the crap there. I really don't know what I'm doing. What else do we have? We have an empty pistol. We have this thing that we have to... Empty stasis fluid container. We have to fill with stasis fluid. Or ice crystals? Cryo tank?
No, that won't work.
I know this won't work, but...
These don't go well together.
Alright.
I don't think this will fit. It doesn't work like that.
Alright. Back in... Oh! Give it a rest.
Kane Corporation, the last truly great company, wants to thank all employees for their dedicated service. This year's profits are up 20% across all sectors. Life expectancy is up 5 years. We are at the best of progress. In the words of every Kane himself, humanity has chosen us to be the world, and together we will not let them down. Kane Corporation.
Maybe.
Technology. Today.
No. Maybe if it... No, that won't work.
Ah, they're whispering again. Get the hell out of here with that crap. Get back out of here. I'm not completely sure what to do at this point. So I'm going to sign off here and ruminate on what to do with these tanks. We want to fill this tank with something. Stasis fluid. Where do we get stasis fluid? And I have a personal data tag. Well, maybe that'll help me, actually, before I do anything. Before I go, let me see if I can get past here, actually.
Maybe. No.
Yeah, that won't work. Alright, so thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. Really exciting. Excited to figure out what the hell to do next. Anyway, thanks again, and always seek adventure.